So last week, we read this text, this passionate text, that started out, "Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence." And it ends with the text about God being the potter and us being the clay. And we were invited to think about how we might allow God to shape us. And I asked you if you would read the text again and again and again. Now, I'm not going to ask anybody to raise their hand and say, "Sally, Sally, I read it 8 times, or 7, or 6, or 5, or 3, or 2, or 1. I'm not going to ask. I just know that the text is so full of these wonderful images that allow us to open ourselves to the presence of God. Whether we need God to rip open the heavens and get right down here right now, because we need God feeling right next to us, right? Or that we are able to call God Mother, Father, tenderly, lovingly, knowing we are cared for. In this season of Advent, we are journeying toward Bethlehem. We are journeying to this moment in time when a child is born, not like any other child, not like the birth of not unlike the birth of Jeremiah, not unlike the birth of his older brother, not unlike the birth of any of us. But this child, whose birth we will celebrate in a few weeks, is the one who comes to show us the way when we are lost, to show us the way when we are discouraged, to show us the way when we don't know what to do or how to do it, this one that is coming. And so if we pay attention to the text, we just might get a sense of what it is we're longing for. So when we're opening those presents, that might give us momentary joy. We're also opening in our hearts a way of being that carries that joy throughout the days and the weeks. And our text today is also from the prophet Isaiah. And it comes at a time when the people are in exile, and yet there are rumblings that another one is coming along who's going to overtake the Babylonians and free the people and allow them to go back from Babylon to Jerusalem if they choose to. This one is going to set them free. And so this is a text of comfort. This is a text that says, okay, you've been in exile long enough, and you can go home now. So it starts with comfort. Were any of you at the Do-It-Yourself Messiah at First United Methodist last Sunday? Or some other Messiah? Or have you ever sung the Messiah, eat parts of the Messiah? Or at any time, or heard it at any time? Right? You cannot read this text, right, without going, "I hear Handel." Right? And if you've sung it enough times, you probably can't even say the words. You've got to start singing the words. And if no one's around, it's okay, because then they can't tell you're not singing the right part. Right? I mean, the whole text just takes you through these wonderful pieces in that amazing oratory. Comfort, my people. Who doesn't need to be comforted this day, huh? These days that we've been living through, we need that comfort. We need to be reminded that God is with us. And this voice crying out, "In the wilderness, prepare a way of the Lord." How are we preparing ourselves to receive this gift? Remember, that's what we were talking about last week, to be open to being malleable, to being clay in God's hand. Maybe even asking Lupus question, well, how long are God's arms? I love it, right? Long enough for sure. Get up to that high mountain. We have good tidings. Speak what is true. Speak what is right. Speak that the word is here. Speak that each of us is here to do what we've been called to do. Speak. Be present. Do not fear. Right there. Do not fear in this time when it feels like all that is happening is fear-mongering. This text says, do not fear. So what do we do if on this day, when we hear this text, we're not feeling particularly comfortable? What do we do if on this day, when we hear this text, maybe we are afraid? What do we do when we hear this text that says, make clear the way of the Lord, and we go, I don't have the strength? What do we do? One of the things we do is we come here. We come here because we know that someone here will experience that sense of comfort. And in their experience of comfort, that comfort will ebb out to us as well. And we come here even if we are afraid, because it doesn't matter how we're feeling when we come here, right? We can come here hardly even awake. We can come here angry. We can come here frustrated. We can come here despairing. We can also come here happy. We can also come here joyful. We can also come here feeling all our power. Because this is faith community. This is why Alex and Dana wanted to have their children baptized here. Not because Pilgrim is the only faith community, but because in their lives this particular faith community has meaning. They know that it's okay to be afraid because someone else won't be. Someone else who is here will not be afraid. And you can sit next to that person, right? You don't have to all sit in the seat you always sit in. Really? You don't have to. Well, I do, because I really like what I can see from that seat. But the rest of you can move around, right? The rest of you can try out different experiences. You see someone who comes in with a smile on their face and you're feeling kind of grumpy, go sit by them. You're seeing somebody who walks in like they've got the world all tied up and you're going, oh, not today, I don't. Go sit by them. You're feeling sad? Sit by somebody that you know is safe. You know these people. That's what faith community is. This text reminds us that comfort is present. This text reminds us that we've got a lot of work to do. We've got to prepare the way for God, right? It doesn't just happen like that. It doesn't just happen because we sit there going, oh yeah, we need to make a bridge. Well, we've got to build that bridge, and we've got to find other people who want to build that bridge with us. Because we don't do any of this alone. We can't do any of this alone. It doesn't work. We end up getting worn out. We end up not being able to move because we forgot that there's someone else who we could sit right next to. There's someone else that we could reach out and say, would you do this thing with me? It's faith community. Comfort. Comfort me, my people. Do not fear. In this world of fear-mongering, do not fear. Because you look around and you see these people who know you and love you. You look around people who know you and love you. We're not alone, we are never alone. On this second Sunday in Advent, on this second Sunday as we journey to Bethlehem, we are reminded that there is comfort. There is comfort in the text. There is comfort in faith community. There is comfort all around. Do not be afraid. I invite you, as I did last week, to take this text and read it later today, tomorrow, Tuesday,
Thursday, Friday, Saturday,
and Sunday morning. And Sunday morning, too! Sue's got a commitment going here. The texts speak to us and help us in this season of waiting and hoping. Do not be afraid.